Hi creators. So this is what we're going to make today. We're going to make some 3D text for your projects. And so it's really not too hard. It uses all free programs besides the 3D exchange program. And I'm assuming most of you guys have that if you have iClone. And so these are the kind of text you're going to get, your 3D text. You can see the shadows and we can change the color of this text. If we want to do some different things, I can change this to a red or a blue or whatever you want. And it's just a pretty simple text, but you know, you can animate this for your next blockbuster film, whatever you want to do. It is true 3D text. So here we go. We're just going to show you how to do this. It's going to be pretty simple. Stay with me, guys. So we're going to start with Blender, and when you open Blender, you're going to get this default block. So let's just delete that, get that out of the way. You're going to press the delete key. It's going to give you this confirmation. So hit delete. Now we need to add some text. So I like to put my location where my text is going to go, pretty much the center of the plane here. And I'm going to hit Shift A to add some text, and I get this menu and say add text. And to edit this text, all we have to do is press the tab key, backspace, and I'm going to type it out as 3D text. And so I'm going to press tab. Now I can rotate this so I can see it a little better. So all I need to do is press the R key and then the X key for the X axis and press 90 degrees, and that'll rotate it up. And so now I can take a look at that. That looks pretty good. Zoom in here. Okay, so you can see this text is pretty flat and it's pretty basic. It's just the Blender basic text. And so I'm gonna wanna put in something a little bit nicer. So over on the right side on this panel are the properties of this text. By hitting the F key up here, we can get to the font selections. And so I'm going to go ahead and load in a different text font by going down here to font under regular. I'm going to press the location to load a new font and go to C windows and fonts. Unless you have something set up different on your machine, that's the default that Windows places the fonts. Let's try this Bastion. And so that looks a little different. And so it's still pretty flat, so we need to extrude this text. So under modifications, extrude, you can just slide that up and we start to see that extrusion. That looks pretty good. Pretty happy with that. And so the next thing that we want to do is, it's still pretty basic. I'm going to go ahead and add a bevel. And so the bevel depth option here, just going to add a little bit of bevel, and that's still pretty sharp there. So I'm going to add some resolution to the bevel, kind of round that off a little bit. That's pretty good. And so look back out at this. These characters are kind of close together. And so I think the next thing I want to do is space these out a little bit, and to get an offset of these characters, we're just going to drag that down just a little bit. If you go too far, it just kind of gets funky, or you go to a plus, it gets too kind of clumped together. So you want to be pretty close to zero, but on the negative side. So this just gives it a little more space, and I'm pretty good with that one there. So the next step is we have text here and it looks really good in Blender, but we really can't export it or do anything with it. So we have to convert this into a mesh that iClone and 3D Exchange can deal with. So to do that, it's pretty simple. We're just going to press the Alt C key. And there's two options, curve from mesh to text, mesh from curve to text. And we're going to choose the bottom option. And we didn't see anything here, but if you press the Tab key now, we can see we have a nice mesh from that text. And so once you do that, from that point on, you can't really edit the text. You can't change what your text says or change your font. So make sure you get it right, but you can do this pretty fast. So If you need to add some more text in later, it's no problem. Good practice for you. And so once we have this as a mesh, all we have to do, well, let's do one thing first. So we have 11,100 vertices, and I want to reduce those a little bit. So to do that, I'm going to reduce the doubles that we don't need. So I'm going to press the A, W key to get the specials menu, and I'm going to hit remove doubles. And so it says it removed 4,458 vertices. That's pretty good. That'll be a little more efficient when we do our rendering in iClone. So if you have a lower powered machine, this is a good option to do. And so now I'm at 6,600 vertices. That's a little bit better. So now we can go ahead and export. I'm going to go to File, Export, and we've got some options here. Oops. And so I recommend using the FBX. That's the easiest one to use with 3D Exchange and iClone. It just seems to work really well. You can also use OBJ. There are some you can do some other things, but just use FBX for your text. You're going to need to choose your location. So just pick your location that you've got and give it a file name. And all you have to do is hit this export FBX. And that's all we need Blender for. And so you can close that down. And then the next step is we're going to open up 3D Exchange and convert that to an iProp that you can import into iClone. So this can be done really fast. I'm just trying to explain each step, so it's taken a little bit more time, but once you get it down, you can do it really fast. Okay, the next step is we need to export or import our mesh into 3D Exchange. And so you need to find the location of that file. And so it'll give you a couple options. We're going to bring in the, you're going to see the iProp there. I did a test on it. So we're going to bring in the FBX. And so all we want to do is just say okay here, and it's going to bring in this 3D text. So a couple of steps here. I like to align this to the ground. And if we want to go ahead and change some materials on this, we can go down here to the materials after we select the actual mesh. So you can pick on it. And if you want to change the color, we'll just make this green color. And so we made a simple 3D text. We didn't do anything with the bevels or the sides, so we didn't create a separate texture for those. That would be a whole nother video to do that. But also, if we zoom in here, we can see it's got some jumps and things like that. So what I like to do is just smooth it out a little bit. So if we want to pick the actual mesh here again, and let's raise this up to 90 or so, go 110, and I want to click this weld vertex and hit auto smooth. That'll just make it a little bit smoother, a little better product. To get it much better out of Blender, there's a whole bunch of steps to do that to get a really great text mesh. But this is really good. It's hard to see any imperfections. And depending on the font you pick, different ones are a lot easier to export into to nice smooth meshes. So just some trial and error there. But as you can see, this looks pretty good and I didn't spend much time on it. So from here, the next step is we just export this into an iClone prop. And we'll call this 3D text. I'm going to hit OK, export that. And so the next step is we're going to open iClone here. And let's just do a new one. Oops, didn't want to do that. New project. I don't want to save it. Okay, so I'm going to go to File, Import, and we called that 3D text. So here it is. It's the iProp. Open, and we're going to have this 3D text in there. And you can see already it has the shadows in our scene, so we know it is a true 3D model, which is really nice. And so that's it. So I know there are a lot of there are some products in the marketplace and other locations to get 3D to buy 3D text. And you can, I think it's actually in the actual Reillusion marketplace. There are some offers there, and those are really great because if you don't want to spend the time doing this, you can just buy those. But if you want to get something specific, or a certain font, this is a great way to do that for your projects, and you can see it's really not too hard to do that. So really appreciate you guys watching again, and please subscribe to the channel, and so I can make some more of these and get some more information out for you guys for iClone and other software for you guys to make some great creative projects. Take care, guys.